In this video, I'm going to introduce you to a really powerful method of making a seed list. A seed list you use to prepare yourself in an optimal way to use in a keyword tool. When you do that, you can find niches that other people don't know about. The thing is that when you input the most common words within your industry in a keyword tool, get related keywords a few times, you end up with the same keywords as everybody else. And that leads to a high competition. The way to do better is to input keywords that other people don't input into the keyword tools. Thereby, you can find your own niches, your own keywords, and you will get a low click price, high conversion, and if you do search engine optimization, your job will be a lot easier. I use the three-step method of making seed lists. First, I find the 10 most searched keywords within the industry. Second, I combine the keywords and name of lists to find lists that I can download. Third, I download them and clean them. Let's go and see how we can find the 10 most searched keywords. I like to get my 10 most searched keywords for finding keyword lists from the belly of the beast herself, Google. I can't remember the URL, so I'm just gonna write keyword tool, and then I see it's already here, so I'm just gonna click here. And up here, you write the keyword that you're interested in, and in this case, it's car and research. And we see down here that we have car, which is interesting, and then we put in order after global monthly searches, which is done like this. So let's start making our list. Car is still a good keyword. Then we look down here, we have like auto, we have if you look down here, we have truck, and we have automobile here. And vehicle, vehicles, they actually mount up to 5. And let's say we want all 10. I see a patterns that you have like auto and autos. You have vehicles and probably vehicle somewhere. And you have car and cars. So just let us just take this and put it in broad. So, put it like this. And now we have the 10 most searched keywords. Now it's time to find a list of keywords within your subject or industry. I'm not gonna tell you how to search, I'm sure you know that already, but I'm just gonna give you some hints of what I have success with. What you do is that you combine the 10 most searched keywords and the name of the lists here. So let me give you an example. Let's say car is one of your most searched keywords, so you take car and combine it with the list and search for car list. Or you could take car and A to Z list and search for that. I don't expect you to go through the 130 combinations and do like 1000 results in Google for each. Go with your gut feeling, look at your industry, think of what gives the best results, and then go for that. This is the name of list I had most success with, except the first one, keyword list. I always hope that someone have done the work for me, but I never found anything usable. So if you're in a hurry, don't look for shortcuts, and don't look for keyword lists. Okay, let's start to see if we can find a keyword list of cars that's already made. I've been doing this search a little bit before, so I know in page 4 there's a big fucking keyword list, or at least it says so. So I click there, the forum is a bit suspect, but it looks like this sample of the keyword list have a lot of good keywords in there. It looks like I have to do with cars. I can see a lot of Mercedes. So I'm just gonna copy the link
and put it up there. And we come to the page, and it looks like we have to wait for a long time. So I'm just going to tell you the results is that it's just a mixed list of keywords, and there's not, I don't think there was any car keywords in it. So it was not a good result. So we have to continue with something else.
When you're searching for your keyword list, I usually categorize it in two groups. The first one is the one that's easy to download. The second is the one that takes effort to download. The first group is easy, I just download it right away. And the second one, I just keep it open in a tab. When I have, I think, enough of the keyword list in the different tabs, I look at five criteria to choose which one I should download. First is size. Size matters. You want as many keywords as possible. Second, time to download. How much time would you be using to download? It's a big difference between 5 minutes and 5 hours. Quality. If the quality impression is bad, and it looks like it's a list that's just taking an hour to make, it's probably stolen from somewhere else, and then it would be more or less the same keyword, so it would not be worth the trouble. And that comes down to uniqueness. You want to look if this keyword list used look unique, if it's a special niche or something like that, so you could add keyword to your list that the other lists don't have already. Then there's a language. Language is straightforward if it's in English, because then you have all the biggest lists there. But if you're making in a smaller language, you might only have like a few lists, and they might be small. And to get and cover a lot of ground, it might be worth the effort to find like a big English keyword list and then download that, put it in Google Translator, and then use that as a keyword list as well. When I have all my list, I usually do three things. First, I've already downloaded all the easy to download lists. Second, I download the biggest list of them all to cover as most ground and mainstream ground as possible. And then I look for uniqueness. I want to have the niche list with unique keywords, and because I want to add extra. And that is really important. So that's usually my steps.
Let's try to find a keyword list without any shortcuts. So we go in Google and write car groceries, and let's try the first results. We see here, this is car repair terms, and we will try to see, let's click on A here. We see we have a list of keywords in like two rows with mixed of ads. Let's see how it goes when we try to copy it. Seems like it's copying it all right. Let's see when we paste it in Notepad, and it looks fine. All these are of course links, so if you don't paste it in Notepad, we will get all the links as well. When we click on B, let's see if I can click on B, it looks okay as well, and we can paste it, so it works fine, and we continue like that.
One thing is finding the keyword list. Another thing is to download them, especially the one that is difficult to download. If you're a programmer, you can always make a script that will download the keywords for you. If you're not, like me, you can use two tools that I usually use is Notepad and Excel. Notepad I use especially because it loses all formatting, links, all kind of things that you don't wanna import because you're only interested in the keywords. I also use the find and replace if I want to make it ready to export it into Excel. In Excel, when you are pasting from Notepad, it will ask if you want to use the import wizard, which I usually want, because you want to isolate all the keywords in one column. And that Excel is really good at. Sometimes you can also copy it directly to Excel, and some kind of magic, you will have the keywords in one column, and you can just download it from there. One thing you're talking about it, let's go and see some examples of it.
I have found a list that is good to illustrate how you work with Notepad and a spreadsheet. We see this is just text. So, and we want to split the keywords from the definition here. So let's start by copying all the list. So here, copy, and we go to Notepad. And we get all the text. As we see here, that you have a double hyphen that is separating the keywords and the definition. But you also have hyphen here, so you cannot just split it by hyphen in the spreadsheet. But you can split it by double hyphen, so we can find some symbols. So we're gonna go for replace, and we're gonna put like two hyphen, I already did it, and we put a special symbol, and replace all. And in here, we just select all and copy, and we go to a spreadsheet. This is OpenOffice, and you can use any spreadsheet you like, but I like OpenOffice in the moment better. So I'm just gonna paste it, and you're gonna click in other, and you're gonna put the symbol that we define, and we can see down here that it always split our keywords in the first column and the definition in the second. We click OK. And we see we have all these keywords just down here, and we can just copy them and put them into our spreadsheet that we made for the purpose, and we are done separating the keywords. If you're only gonna know one page of finding lists in the internet, this is the page. Wikipedia is a great place to find lists. There's a huge amount of them, which this page shows. This page shows a list of pages that have lists in them. So you have to click at least two times to get to an actual list of something. So let's go down these thousands of pages that have lists on them to see if we can find some with car. Here we have automobiles, and we see here there's like hundreds of lists of cars that we could use for our keyword report. But since this is our last example, I have found a bit challenging list. This list is a big mixture. You see, if you just download the text, we have like continent, country, we have these dots in front, spaces, if you go a little bit down, we see that we got like links here in Asia for other lists, and all different kind of things. Here in North America we have Canada, we have four different columns, and it's gonna make it quite difficult. So what you're gonna do is that you're gonna go to the source code, which normally you do by right click and show source code, and you have the source code here. So you just select all, copy, go to the Notepad, paste it, and we're gonna look for the famous car, Zhongying, which is like the first in our list. So just copy, and we go back to Notepad, and we check find, and we have it here, find, no, it is up, find, and we have it here. And what we look at is the first part, which is like this, that we're gonna replace it with a symbol. And we're also gonna replace the last bit. So let's take this one as the first one, and we go to replace. We already have something, so we have this, and we replace with this symbol, and replace all. And then we saw that in the end, we have like this symbol that we're gonna be like replace all as well. Then we're gonna select all and copy and go to our spreadsheet. In the spreadsheet we're gonna put others and we're gonna put this symbol and hope it goes well. And as you see there's many things. But let's say that we try to find our famous car, something, let's find, and we find it down here a little bit. So it is down here, and if you go down, we can see other cars that's in here, other names of cars. And it's also mixed with other things, but let's see if we can, here looks quite well, but let's see if we can delete that later. So we're just gonna go down, down, until we reach the stop of the list. Let's see. I think this looks like the last bit. Yes, this is the last bit. So I'm just gonna copy that, and I go to a different sheet, spreadsheet, and I just paste it down here. And let's put it in alphabetic order, because then we can take, we can have a look at these, and then we can just like delete. Yes, I want to delete. Go down a little bit. And we're just gonna clean here, because it takes too long time to find a solution of getting these extra things. It's just get here anyway. And let's see. Oh, there's one more. Delete. Yes, all of it. And we read the button, so I'm just gonna put it in alphabetic order again. Click go up, copy all of them, and then we're gonna open Notepad. And even if it was a difficult list, now we have it in Notepad, and we can put it into our keyword tool.
Don't worry if it takes you a bit of time in the beginning. You will improve fast, and then you have advantage compared to other online marketing professionals. I see a surprising large numbers that doesn't know how to make a seed list. And it is the basic to get a good keyword report, which you know is the basic of getting high conversions, low cost per click, and your search engine optimizing effort is much easier when there's not a lot of competition and it is niche keywords. So I wish you good luck.